Hey, a few more things for you. How
Okay.
far away under the model that the flat earthers believe is the sun and moon? Like how what's the best guess for what it is above the earth?
Couple thousand, I'll convert a couple thousand kilometers, maybe.
1,200
I, we don't know to be sure, but I don't, even though snow globe is an easier thing to show people, I kind of treat it like a shallow sports stadium.
Okay.
So, because sports stadiums, they're squatty, but they don't have a really high overarching roof because you don't need one.
Are
And so,
they at the same height, the sun and the moon?
maybe I'd like to think so. I mean, with the whole eclipse thing and how they seem tend to line up. Yeah, sure. Why not?
But that would be the problem. We wouldn't be able to have if they were at the same height, we couldn't have an eclipse because obviously the moon needs to be lower than the sun to cast the shadow down on the earth.
Yeah, don't know exactly what the optics are doing with the sun and the moon.
What about
Don't
the
know.
lunar eclipse? That's obviously one that gets
Oh,
people.
the lunar eclipse, that's one of my things.
So just for people, hang on a sec, just for people who don't quite understand the terminology, which lunar eclipse is where the earth is said to be between the moon and the sun, and on
Yeah, where you
a
get
flat earth that couldn't happen.
the blood moon, which is one of my points where I say that the eclipse shadow is too small. Meaning if the moon is 2,000 miles wide, why is the eclipse blackout zone only 70 miles wide? And science comes back, well, it's this condensation like a magnifying glass, only with a shadow and blah blah blah. It's like, okay, that's fine. If you want to go with that route, then why don't we see the
So
same thing?
remember at the start of this conversation, one of the things you said was rather than saying, I'm going to disprove the globe, that's wrong because we're going to say, I'm going to prove the earth, which is rather than saying it can't be that what the globe said, what I want to know from you is under the flat earth model, can you explain to me what the lunar eclipse is?
What I'm saying is, well, okay, first off, the lunar eclipse is artificial from minute one. No different than, and it's completely wrong, which doesn't make any sense. I would have thought, I don't know if they're throwing us breadcrumbs on purpose to find. Meaning, when you go into a planetarium, how do you have waxing and waning crescents of the moon? That's because they just dim parts of the moon. That's all they're doing in a planetarium. I don't think really you're
So
doing that much.
a lot of this for you, it seems to come back to there really is, I'll use the word an entity, turning knobs in control of this whole thing. Like you're saying, you don't know about the Antarctic 24-hour day. Maybe there's more light, which would only obviously be relevant in the Southern Hemisphere summer, which means they would need to be turned off in the northern, northern hemisphere summer. Are you actually saying that there is? I don't know what word you want to put to it, but some kind of entity or group of entities physically control. You said they fire the meteorites like they're having fun with a gun thing.
I
Actually,
do. At the very least,
somewhere turning knobs, equivalent of controlling what's going on and actively manipulating in real time what's happening on Earth.
I do. I absolutely 100% think that we are living in an artificial environment. At the very least, it's mechanical in nature. I know people hate using the word because it's old timey, or it's digital. Which it's more likely. I mean, I've been the first one to say, like, look, God's a programmer. I can tell by some of the stuff that's happening out there. The double slit experiment, a perfect example of programming in this case. Which is why do we, when we program things, why are we seeing the same things that we are programming to save resources? Why are we seeing that in real life? Why are we seeing it in our world? Which is straight out of the 13th floor, if you remember that movie from the late 90s. We're seeing that. So yes, absolutely, I'm saying that.
But that actually also, and I don't mean this in a disrespectful way, but gives you a lot of outs because
It does.
you can kind
Sure.
of go, I don't know, that's the what is it? The flying spaghetti monsters controlling that. I don't know the answer to that.
Yeah.